Unit 15. Polymers. Copolymerization has been used by nature in polypeptides, which may contain as many as 20 different amino acids. Chemists are still far behind. Do you think that daily life would have been easier and colorful without the discovery and varied application of polymers? The use of polymers in the manufacture of plastic buckets, cups and saucers, children's toys, packaging bags, synthetic clothing materials, automobiles, tires, gears and seals, electrical insulating materials and machine parts has completely revolutionized the daily life as well as the industrial scenario. Indeed, the polymers are the backbone of four major industries, and they are plastics, elastomers, fibers and paints and varnishes. The word polymer is coined from two Greek words. Poly means many and mer means unit or part. The term polymer is defined as very large molecules having high molecular mass. These are also referred to as macromolecules, which are formed by joining of repeating structural units on a large scale. The repeating structural units are derived from some simple and reactive molecules known as monomers and are linked to each other by covalent bonds. The process of formation of polymers from respective monomers is called polymerization. 15.1 Classification of polymers. There are several ways of classification of polymers based on some special considerations. One of the common classifications of polymers is based on source from which polymer is derived. Under this type of classification, there are three subcategories. Number 1. Natural polymers. These polymers are found in plants and animals. Examples are proteins, cellulose, starch, some resins and rubber. Number 2. Semi-synthetic polymers. Cellulose derivatives as cellulose acetate, that is rayon, and cellulose nitrate, etc. are the usual example of the subcategory. Number 3. Synthetic polymers. A variety of synthetic polymers as plastic, that is polythene, synthetic fibers, that is nylon 6,6, and synthetic rubbers, that is Buna S, are examples of man-made polymers extensively used in daily life as well as in industry. Polymers can also be classified on the basis of their structure, molecular forces, or modes of polymerization. 15.2 Types of polymerization reaction. There are two broad types of polymerization reactions, that is the addition or chain growth polymerization and condensation or step growth polymerization. In this type of polymerization, the molecules of the same monomer or different monomers add together on a large scale to form a polymer. The monomers used are unsaturated compounds, example alkenes, alkadienes and their derivatives. This mode of polymerization leads to an increase in chain length and chain growth can take place through the formation of either free radicals or ionic species. However, the free radical governed addition or chain growth polymerization is the most common mode. Number 1. Free radical mechanism. A variety of alkenes or dienes and their derivatives are polymerized in the presence of a free radical generating initiator, that is catalyst, like benzoyl peroxide, acetyl peroxide, tert-butyl peroxide, etc. For example, the polymerization of ethene to polythene consists of heating or exposing to light a mixture of ethene with a small amount of benzoyl peroxide initiator. The process starts with the addition of phenyl free radical formed by the peroxide to the ethene double bond, thus generating a new and larger free radical. This step is called chain initiating step. As this radical reacts with another molecule of ethene, another bigger sized radical is formed. The repetition of this sequence with new and bigger radicals carries the reaction forward and the step is termed as chain propagating step. Ultimately, at some stage, the product radical thus formed reacts with another radical to form the polymerized product. This step is called the chain terminating step. The sequence of steps involved in the formation of polythene are depicted as follows. Chain initiation steps, C6H5 plus CH2 double bond CH2 gives out C6H5 single bond CH2 single bond CH2 free radical. And chain propagating steps, that is C6H5 CH2 single bond CH2 free radical plus CH2 double bond CH2 gives out C6H5CH2, single bond CH2, free radical, and it gives C6H5CH2, whole N, CH2, single bond, free radical CH2. Chain terminating step. For the termination of the long chain, these free radicals can combine in different ways to form polyethene. One mode of termination of chain is shown as under. When two molecules of C6H5CH2CH2 whole N, single bond CH2, single bond CH2 free radical, and it forms C6H5CH2CH2 whole N, CH2CH2CH2CH2CH2 whole N, C6H5, that is polyethene. The addition polymers formed by the polymerization of a single monomeric species are known as homopolymers. For example, polyethene discussed above is a homopolymer. The polymers made by addition polymerization from two different monomers are termed as copolymers. Buna S, which is formed by polymerization of buta-1,3-diene and styrene, is an example of copolymer formed by addition polymerization. NCH2 double bond CH, single bond CH, double bond CH2, that is 1,3-butadiene, plus NC6H5CH double bond CH2, that is styrene, forms CH2CH double bond CH, single bond CH2, single bond CH, C6H5, and CH2 whole N, buta, that is butadiene styrene copolymer, that is Buna S. 15.2.1.2 Some important addition polymers. A. Polyethene. Polyethenes are linear or slightly branched long chain molecules. These are capable of repeatedly softening on heating and hardening on cooling and are thus thermoplastic polymers. There are two types of polyethene as given below. Number 1. Low density polyethene. It is obtained by the polymerization of ethene under high pressure of 1000 to 2000 atmospheres at a temperature of 350 K to 570 K in the presence of traces of dioxygen or a peroxide initiator, that is catalyst. The low density polyethene, that is LDP, is obtained through the free radical addition and hydrogen atom abstraction. It has highly branched structure. These polymers have a straight chain structure with some branches as shown below. Low density polyethene is chemically inert and tough but flexible and a poor conductor of electricity. Hence, it is used in the insulation of electricity carrying wires and manufacture of squeeze bottles, toys and flexible pipes. Number 2. High density polyethene. It is formed when addition polymerization of ethene takes place in a hydrocarbon solvent in the presence of a catalyst such as triethyl aluminium and titanium tetrachloride, that is Ziegler-Natta catalyst, its name it is, at a temperature of 333 Kelvin to 343 Kelvin and under a pressure of 6 to 7 atmospheres. High density polyethene, that is HDP, thus produced consists of linear molecules as shown below and has a high density due to close packing. Such polymers are also called linear polymers. High density polymers are also chemically inert and more tough and hard. It is used for manufacturing buckets, dustbins, bottles, pipes, etc. B. Polytetrafluoroethene, that is Teflon. Teflon is manufactured by heating tetrafluoroethene with a free radical or persulfate catalyst at high pressures. It is chemically inert and resistant to attack by corrosive reagent. It is used in making oil seals and gaskets and also used for non-stick surface coated utensils. NCF2 double bond CF2, that is tetrafluoroethene. And in the presence of high pressure and catalyst, it forms CF2-CF2 whole N, that is Teflon. C. Polyacrylonitrile. The addition polymerization of acrylonitrile in presence of a peroxide catalyst leads to the formation of polyacrylonitrile. NCH2 double bond CSCN, that is acrylonitrile. And in the polymerization, in the presence of peroxide catalyst, it forms CH2 single bond CH2CN to the whole N, polyacrylonitrile. Polyacrylonitrile is used as a substitute for wool in making commercial fibers as Orlon or Acrylan. 15.2.2 Condensation polymerization or step growth polymerization. This type of polymerization generally involves a repetitive condensation reaction between two bifunctional or trifunctional monomeric units. These polycondensation reactions may result in the loss of some simple molecules as water, alcohol, hydrogen, chloride, etc., and lead to the formation of high molecular mass condensation polymers. In these reactions, the product of each step is again a bifunctional species and a sequence of condensation goes on. Since each step produces a distinct functionalized species and is independent of each other, this process is also called as step growth polymerization. The formation of tetralene or dacron by the interaction of ethylene glycol and terephthalic acid is an example of this type of polymerization. 15.2.2.1 Some important condensation polymers. A. Polyamides. These polymers possessing amide linkages are important examples of synthetic fibers and are termed as nylons. The general method of preparation consist of the condensation polymerization of diamines with dicarboxylic acids or condensation of amino acids or their lactams. Nylons. Number 1. Nylon 6,6. It is prepared by the condensation polymerization of hexamethylene diamine with adipic acid under high pressure and at high temperature. NHOOC CH2 whole 4 COOH plus NH2N CH2 whole 6 NH2 at high pressure and temperature is 553 K, and it forms nylon 6,6 plus NH2O. Nylon 6,6 is fiber forming solid. It possesses high tensile strength. This characteristic can be attributed to the strong intermolecular forces like hydrogen bonding. These strong forces also lead to close packing of chains and thus impart crystalline nature. Nylon 6,6 is used in making sheets, bristles for brushes and in textile industry. Number 2. Nylon 6. It is obtained by heating caprolactam with water at a high temperature. Caprolactam at temperature 533 through 543 Kelvin and in the presence of H2O, it forms nylon 6. Nylon 6 is used for the manufacture of tire cords, fabrics and ropes. B. Polyesters. These are the polycondensation products of dicarboxylic acids and diols. Dacron or terylene is the best known example of polyesters. It is manufactured by heating a mixture of ethylene glycol and terephthalic acid at 420 to 460 Kelvin in the presence of zinc acetate antimony trioxide catalyst as per the reactions given earlier. Dacron fiber terylene, that is crease resistant and is used in blending with cotton and wool fibers and also as glass reinforcing materials in safety helmets, etc. C. Phenol, formaldehyde polymer, that is bakelite and related polymers. Phenol formaldehyde polymers are the oldest synthetic polymers. These are obtained by the condensation reaction of phenol with formaldehyde in the presence of either an acid or a base catalyst. The reaction starts with the initial formation of ortho and or para hydroxy methyl phenol derivatives, which further react with phenol to form compounds having rings joined to each other through CH2 groups. The initial product could be a linear product, Novolac, used in paints. Novolac on heating with formaldehyde undergoes cross-linking to form an infusible solid mass called bakelite. It is thermosetting polymer which cannot be reused or remolded. Thus, bakelite is formed by cross-linking of linear chains of the polymer Novolac. Bakelite is used for making combs, phonograph, records, electrical switches and handles of various utensils. D. Melamine formaldehyde polymer. Melamine formaldehyde polymer is formed by the condensation polymerization of melamine and formaldehyde. Here the melamine, and when it combines with formaldehyde, that is HCHO, and it forms a resin intermediate. And after the polymerization, it will form melamine polymer. And it is used in manufacture of unbreakable crockery. 15.2.3 Copolymerization. Copolymerization is a polymerization reaction in which a mixture of more than one monomeric species is allowed to polymerize and form a copolymer. The copolymer can be made not only by chain growth polymerization but by step growth polymerization also. It contains multiple units of each monomer used in the same polymeric chain. For example, a mixture of buta-1,3-diene and styrene can form a copolymer. 1,3-butadiene, when it reacts with the styrene, it forms butadiene-styrene copolymer. Copolymers have properties quite different from homopolymers. For example, butadiene styrene copolymer is quite tough and is a good substitute for natural rubber. It is used for the manufacture of auto tires, floor tiles, footwear components, cable insulation, etc. 15.2.4 Rubber. Number 1. Natural rubber. Rubber is a natural polymer and possesses elastic properties. It is also termed as elastomeric polymer. In elastomeric polymers, the polymer chains are held together by the weak intermolecular forces. These weak binding forces permit the polymer to be stretched. A few crosslinks are introduced in between the chains, which help the polymer to retract to its original position after the force is released. Rubber has a variety of uses. It is manufactured from rubber latex, which is a colloidal depression of rubber in water. This latex is obtained from the rubber tree, which is found in India, Sri Lanka, Indonesia, Malaysia, and South America. Natural rubber may be considered as a linear polymer of isoprene, that is 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene, and is also called as cis-1,4-polyisoprene. The cis polyisoprene molecule consists of various chains held together by weak van der Waals interaction and has a coiled structure. Thus, it can be stretched like a spring and exhibits elastic properties. Vulcanization of rubber. Natural rubber becomes soft at high temperature, that is greater than 335 Kelvin, and brittle at low temperatures, that is less than 283 Kelvin, and shows high water absorption capacity. It is soluble in non-polar solvent and is non-resistant to attack by oxidizing agents. To improve upon these physical properties, a process of vulcanization is carried out. This process consists of heating a mixture of raw rubber with sulfur and an appropriate additive at a temperature range between 370 Kelvin to 415 Kelvin. On vulcanization, sulfur forms crosslinks at the reactive sites of double bonds and thus the rubber gets stiffened. In the manufacture of tire rubber, 5% of sulfur is used as a cross-linking agent. The probable structures of vulcanized rubber molecules are depicted below. Structures you have to see from the book. Number 2. Synthetic rubbers. Synthetic rubber is any vulcanizable rubber like polymer which is capable of getting stretched to twice its length. However, it returns to its original shape and size as soon as the external stretching force is released. The synthetic rubbers are either homopolymers of 1,3-butadiene derivatives or copolymers of 1,3-butadiene or its derivatives with another unsaturated monomer. Preparation of synthetic rubbers. Number 1. Neoprene. Neoprene or polychloroprene is formed by the free radical polymerization of chloroprene. NCH2 double bond CCl CH double bond CH2, and that is chloroprene, and its another name is 2-chloro-1,3-buta-1,3-diene. And after the polymerization, it forms neoprene, that is CH2-CCl-CH2-N. It has superior resistance to vegetable and mineral oils. It is used for manufacturing conveyor belts, gaskets and hoses. Number 2. Buna-N. You have already studied about Buna-S in section 15.1.3. Buna-N is obtained by the copolymerization of 1,3-buta-1,3-diene and acrylonitrile in the presence of a peroxide catalyst. 1,3-butadiene plus acrylonitrile, after the copolymerization, it forms Buna-N. It is resistant to the action of petrol, lubricating oil and organic solvents. It is used in making oil seals, tank lining, etc. 15.3 Molecular mass of polymers. Polymer properties are closely related to their molecular mass, size and structure. The growth of the polymer chain during their synthesis is dependent upon the availability of the monomers in the reaction mixture. Thus, the polymer sample contains chains of varying lengths and hence its molecular mass is always expressed as an average. The molecular mass of polymers can be determined by chemical and physical methods. A large number of polymers are quite resistant to the environmental degradation processes and are thus responsible for the accumulation of polymeric solid waste materials. These solid waste cause acute environmental problems and remain undegraded for quite a long time. In view of the general awareness and concern for the problems created by the polymeric solid waste, certain new biodegradable synthetic polymers have been designed and developed. These polymers contain functional groups similar to the functional groups present in biopolymers. Aliphatic polyesters are one of the important classes of biodegradable polymers. Some important examples are given below. Number 1. Poly-beta-hydroxybutyrate -co-beta-hydroxyvalerate, that is PHBV. It is obtained by the copolymerization of 3-hydroxybutanoic acid and 3-hydroxypentanoic acid. PHBV is used in specialty packaging, orthopedic devices, and in controlled release of drugs. PHBV undergoes bacterial degradation in the environment. CH3CHOH, CH2COOH, that is 3-hydroxybutanoic acid, plus CH3CH2CHOH, CH2COOH, 3-hydroxypentanoic acid, and it forms PHBV. Number 2, nylon 2, nylon 6. It is an alternating polyamide copolymer of glycine, that is NH2CH2COOH, and amino caproic acid, that is NH2CH2 whole 5 COOH, and is biodegradable. Can you write the structure of this copolymer? 15.5 polymers of commercial importance. Besides the polymers already discussed, some other commercially important polymers along with their structures and uses are given below in table 15.1. Some other commercially important polymers. Name of polymer, monomer, structure and uses. I will read the name of polymer, monomer and its uses. Polypropene, its monomer is propene and its use is manufacture of ropes, toys, pipes, fibers, etc. Next one is polystyrene and its monomer is styrene and it is used as insulator, wrapping material, manufacturing of toys, radio and television cabinets. Next one is polyvinyl chloride, that is PVC, and its monomer is vinyl chloride and its uses are manufacture of raincoats, handbags, vinyl flooring, water pipes, etc. After that, urea formaldehyde resin and its monomers are urea and formaldehyde and it is used for making unbreakable cups and laminated sheets. After that, glyptal and its monomers are ethylene glycol and phthalic acid. And it is used in manufacture of paints and lacquers. And after that, the last one is bakelite and its monomers are phenol, formaldehyde, and it is used for making combs, electrical switches, handles of utensils and computer disks. Summary. Polymers are defined as high molecular mass macromolecules which consist of repeating structural units derived from the corresponding monomers. These polymers may be of natural or synthetic origin and are classified in a number of ways. In the presence of an organic peroxide initiator, the alkenes and their derivatives undergo addition polymerization or chain growth polymerization through a free radical mechanism. Polyethylene, Teflon, or lawn, etc. are formed by addition polymerization of an appropriate alkene or its derivative. Condensation polymerization reactions are shown by the interaction of bi- or polyfunctional monomers containing NH2OH and COOH groups. This type of polymerization proceeds through the elimination of certain simple molecules as H2O, CH3OH, etc. Formaldehyde reacts with phenol and melamine to form the corresponding condensation polymer products. The condensation polymerization progresses through step by step and is also called as a step growth polymerization. Nylon, bakelite and dacron are some of the important examples of condensation polymers. However, a mixture of two unsaturated monomers exhibits copolymerization and forms a copolymer containing multiple units of each monomer. Natural rubber is a cis 1,4 polyisoprene and can be made more tough by the process of vulcanization with sulfur. Synthetic rubbers are usually obtained by copolymerization of alkene and 1,3-butadiene derivatives. In view of the potential environmental hazards of synthetic polymeric waste, certain biodegradable polymers such as PHBV and nylon 2, nylon 6 are developed as alternatives. Chapter completed. Thank you so much. See you soon in the next video.